إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, there is a verse in Surah An-Nur. The scholars of tafsir called it or label it to be ayat al-tamkeen, the ayah of tamkeen. Tamkeen is being empowered, being free to take your own decisions, no interventions in your life. You have independence once it comes to making your decisions as an individual, as a community, as an ummah. The verse reads, Wa'ad Allah. Allah has promised. Alladhina amanu. Those among you who believe. Minkum. Alladhina amanu minkum. From you. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ And they confirm their iman with the doing of righteous deeds. يُصَلُّونَ وَيُزَكُّونَ وَيَصُومُونَ Righteous deeds. Number one, لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ He will, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will certainly grant them successions to the leadership in earth. To the leadership in earth. This is number one. كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ If we look at our history as Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted the first or generations of Muslims successions succession to the leadership in earth in different times of history because they believed and they confirmed their faith with the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you empowerment in earth. Two, وَلَيُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمُ الَّذِي ارْتَضَى لَهُمْ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them the authority to practice the religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen for them freely. A sister can wear her hijab and she still gets a job. A brother can have his beard and he still gets a job. He can look as a Muslim and he still can have You will practice your deen. You can own a house without going through mortgage, which is riba. You will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn your resources to be halal resources, that you will practice your deen freely. وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا. And he will exchange their anxiety and fear with security. They will feel secured. Provided, يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا. That they worship Allah alone and they do not associate someone in worship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. هذه الآية. This is ayat al-tamkeen. You will normally see the people who come and say establishing the sharia on earth. And the people actually who say, well, let's bring back the khilafah. Huh? You know, since the falling down of the Ottoman Empire, they come. They normally, you find this verse in their literature. Oh, shayf, Allah said, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ. You will read the verse. You will spot the verse there. التمكين يا إخوة. Seeking succession to be leaders in earth is something that occupies everybody. Muslims or non-Muslims. Every jama'ah, every group. يعني كل طائفة في الأرض تبحث عن التمكين. They want to be empowered. Huh? Why do you see war? Why a country takes army and go attack another country? Why? They want to subdue them. They want to have power over them. But here is what this verse tells us. That tamkeen al-Muslim, al-Mu'min, is different to tamkeen al-Kafir. I'm going to use the word tamkeen. Again, tamkeen means to be granted succession to the leadership in earth. Tamkeen, to be empowered. The curriculum for a believer to be empowered in earth is different to the curriculum of a non-Muslim. A non-Muslim uses army, sometimes financial. They tell you, you're not going to receive these aids if you do not strip naked your women. Huh? You change your deen. The women, freedom of the women, fashion, if you do not spread the fashion. So they get their ideology. Somehow through financial pressure. And if you do not abide by these conditions, okay, there is no more aids. So they use power. They use pressure. Sometimes they host Muslims who are washy-washy about their deen. They speak the language, they bring them here, they support them, and they go out there and they spread that ideology. So they use different methods to outpower people and get their agenda. And it's fair, come on. I mean, it's fair. I'm not nagging about it. I mean, they are smart. But here is the issue. We cannot do the same. We can't. As Muslims, we can't. A Muslim, a believer, if he is empowered in earth, he's going to feed the hungry. He's not going to pay off the farmers in order not to grow corn when the rest of the world is starving. La. The Muslim will feed the hungry. The Muslims does not get empowered to be a tyrant. La. A Muslim, a believer, gets empowered in earth to help humanity, to spread the goodness in earth, to spread tawheed. Shuf. Alladhina immakkannahum fil ardi. Those people whom, if we empower them in earth, أقاموا الصلاة, they will pray. وآتوا الزكاة, they will pay the zakah. وأمروا بالمعروف ونهوا عن المنكر. and they will enjoin what is good and forbid what is evil. And these are attributes of this ummah. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. And this is the duty and the role of this ummah, brothers and sisters in Islam. I don't know for how long are we going to just keep sleeping. Our job is to share Islam with the non-Muslims peacefully, kindly, with the idea that we cannot force them. We just want to present it to you in a kind way. If you like it, take it. If not, between you and Allah, لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينُ. A Muslim, يا إخوة حتى الحيوانات, even the animals. Animals in our religion, we have a whole chapter in the Sunnah about treating the animals. يعني في مستدرك الحاكم حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تتخذ الدواب كراسي. Don't use the donkey or the horse as a chair. يقول لك الحمار أعزكم الله, when it's standing, not moving, don't sit on it. Because it has four legs. Very uncomfortable. يقول لك شوف شوف سبحان الله حتى الحية الوزعة, شوف a harmful I would say animal, مش زواحف, you could say animal, like a snake. If you kill it from one time, you get more rewarded than striking it twice. A snake, if you hit that snake one time, kill it, you get twice the reward of hitting it twice. You see the logic behind it? That you're going to make it not, you're not going to make it painful. حتى الحيوان الذبيحة إن الله كتب الإحسان على كل شيء فإذا ذبحتم فأحسنوا الذبحة وإذا قتلتم فأحسنوا القتلة وليحدد أحدكم شفرته وليرح ذبيحته. When you slay an animal to eat, make sure that you making it a comfortable, make it comfortable, make sure that you're sharpening the knife. هذا والدين دين. This is all from Allah. From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فالمسلم, a Muslim, we do not get empowered in order to have a B-man and my income is 200,000 and 300,000 and I'm a million. لا يا أخي, لا 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 لا. You use all your resources to help the deen of Allah. Again, I'm trying to inform my brothers today about the curriculum for tamkeen as a Muslim vis-a-vis non-Muslim. So number one, when we get empowered, we have a different agenda. The second thing, we believe in the depth of our hearts that Allah is the one who will grant us the succession. Look, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ. They ask you, O Muhammad, about ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ, the man in Surah Al-Kahf. قُلْ سَأَتْلُ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْهُ ذِكْرًا. شوف, إِنَّا مَكَّنَّا. We empowered him. We empowered, Allah empowered him. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the children of Israel at the time of the Pharaoh killed their children, newborn, slayed them, and he's using them as slaves. And they were the Muslims at the time. وَنُرِيدُ, and we want, أَنَّمُنَّ عَلَى الَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنَجْعَلَهُمْ أَئِمَّةً ونجعلهم الوارثين ونمكن. So Allah is the one who will give that, will grant that. Why I'm saying this, brothers? Because there is some sort of a epidemic in the minds of a lot of Muslims that for you to help the deen, you must disobey Allah. And this is the analogy that they use. Ya akhi, you tell them riba is haram, usury is haram. If you buy a house, mortgage, that's haram. They go like, ya sheikh, we end up with tax cuts, and we end up with this and that, and we can use these resources for Allah. Ya rajul, da rabbina a'lan alik al-harb. Rabbul alameen declares war on someone who pays and receives usury. And if you believe that victory comes from Allah, huh? For a Muslim, for a believer, victory comes from Allah. You cannot disobey Allah to make the deen of Allah victorious. You can't. I'm sorry, this is a little bit harsh on a lot of us, but hey, at least inside you feel guilty, akhi. But don't live with the motion that's halalun, halalun, halalun. Huh? Halalun, halal, mish halalun, wala halalun, wala halalun. Huh? It's riba. At least feel guilty about it. Maybe that feeling of guilt will drive you one day to come out of it. I'm not asking you to do this right now and make break your you know, contract. I mean, be careful. But I just want to imagine this: a woman who goes to belly dance, huh? And then with the wage, she pays it in sadaqah. Exactly. You will like that. It's the same analogy. We want to be empowered. We want to be strong. Ya Rajil, Rabbul Alameen, given the whole Ummah an event at the very beginning of its history to be crystal clear. Crystal clear. What is it? The event of Badr. 300 people, ill-equipped, outnumbered, hungry. Abu Ubaidah used to say, we used to suck the date for a whole day and drink water because there is no food. A date, suck on it and just drink water. 1,000 marching, strong, well equipped, they came to fight. Prepared. When the Prophet asked one of them, how many camels do you slay a day? 10. 10 camels to eat a day. وَمَا النَّصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. Victory comes from Allah, ya akhi. Victory comes from Allah. All what you have to do is obey Allah and His Messenger and do the best to your capacity. That's it. وَأَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُ. This is the fighting front. We're not talking about that here. Huh? But this can apply to anything. You obey Allah and His Messenger and you do your best. This verse, brothers and sisters in Islam, I have shared with you, subhanAllah, has an amazing context. Amazing context. Siyaq yani. Number one, the verse in Surah An-Nur. Surah called An-Nur. And it is verse number 55. The scholars of tafsir have divided Surah An-Nur into two main sections. One section, sets of commands, laws, boundaries that guard the moral standard of a Muslim community. Talking about adultery, and adultery is a road to destruction. Now, how can you stop adultery from happening? Let's get married. Let's encourage the institution of marriage. Let's not make the dowry expensive. Let's make it possible for people to get married. Ankihu, marry even the poor. Don't, no problem. Look for the righteous. No problem. Lower your gaze. Don't look. Do not mix. Very, subhanAllah, social things that we practice every day. Things that we can practice every day. That's section number one. Comes in section number two. The attitude of the people once it comes to these commands. The reaction. A group will say, we hear and we obey. Lower your gaze. Hear and obey. Marry, do not commit adultery. Hear and obey. Just rent a house. I mean, you don't have to own a house, okay? Why don't you think about the house in Jannah? I mean, you're going to last here for eternity? There is a house in Jannah. Think about the house in Jannah. Hear and obey. You like to drink alcohol? There is wine in Jannah. Hear and obey. Stop. You like to get high? In Jannah. Hear and obey. This is one. And this is the people whom Allah will grant empowerment. Because إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. Those are the group who will be granted succession or empowerment in earth. There are two other groups. One group that is very simple. And you know what? We respect them. They say, ya akhi, I'm not interested in your Islam. I'm not interested in your message. And I'm not interested in all of this. Kafir. Yakfir. Khalas. This person, I respect this person. Because he's clear. And subhanAllah, one of the most amazing things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about those three types of people. I invite you today to go home and read the first two pages, the half page, and then page number two, and page number three of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah actually subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about those three kinds in relation to the Quran. Alif Lam Mim. By Alif Lam Mim. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. This book indeed, there is no doubtness about it, doubt about it, will be guidance. But for a group of people who are المتقين, هدى للمتقين. What are the attributes of a متقين? Who are those people? Number one, الذين يؤمنون بالغيب. I tell them there is Jannah, there is hellfire. I believe it. He doesn't come and say, where it is? Show it to me. I tell him there is Allah. I say, yes, there is Allah. Khalas. He is not going to say, show me Allah. Where is Allah? I have to see Allah before I believe. Bil ghaib. Iman. Wa yuqimuna as-salah. Wa mimma razaqnahum yunfiqoon. They perform the prayers and they spend of that which we bestowed upon them. And they believe in what was revealed before you, O Muhammad, the Torah and the Gospel, and what was revealed to you, O Muhammad, the Quran. This is the group who will receive guidance from this book. طيب, what about the second group? الكفار. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَأَنذَرْتَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. They already set their agenda. I'm not interested in your Islam. Not interested in your religion. Khalas. Khatam Allah. Two verses. In Surah An-Nur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that group in one verse only. One verse only in relation to the commands that are mentioned in Surah An-Nur. لا تحسبن الذين كفروا معجزين في الأرض ومأواهم النار ولبئس المصير. Khalas. Khalas, because their agenda is clear. هو غير مسلم. You know what to expect from a non-Muslim. Khalas. By the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually told them that you're not going to be receiving the same punishment that a hypocrite receives. The hypocrite is the most damaging force in the Muslim community. And this is group number three. And you will find out that the Quran spoke about them, because I want you to be careful with this. You cannot go to somebody and say you're a hypocrite. You can't. You cannot, because you don't know what's in his heart. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you about a lot of signs. وَلَتَعْرِفَنَّهُمْ فِي لَحْنِ الْقَوْلِ. They will normally will throw a word or two that you know. So you're careful. Because their agenda is the destruction of the ummah. They are not believers. They are not. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ. Look at this. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. They are deceiving the believers. The same exact thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah An-Nur regarding these commands, lowering the gaze and not mixing, and the women wearing their hijab and all of this. وَيَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالرَّسُولِ وَأَطَعْنَا. They will say what? We believe in Allah and His Messenger and we obey. ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مِّنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. They say, but when they are asked to show this in action, they turn away. وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Here it is. وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ. يَا أَخِي تَبْ تَعَالَى. Okay, let me show you the Quran and the Sunnah. Here it is. Let's appoint the Prophet ﷺ to be the judge. Here it is. They say, no, we're not interested. إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. They turn away. وَنَزَلَتْ هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ فِي وَإِنْ يَكُنْ لَهُمُ الْحَقِّ يأتوا إليه مذعنين. كما أخرج ابن أبي حاتم والمعجم الكبير للطبراني عن ابن عباس أن أبا برز الأسلمي كان كاهنا في الجاهلية وكان يقضي بين يهود. أبو برز الأسلمي رضي الله عنه, before he became a Muslim, he used to be a judge who actually arbitrates between the Jews. He would help the Jews in Medina to settle their disputes. Of course, when the Prophet ﷺ came to Medina, where the city where he migrated to, he became the appointed leader of Medina. Normally, you have to go to him as a judge. But look at this. A Muslim and a Jew had a conflict. So they said to him, let's go to the Messenger of Allah. The Muslim said no. You know why? Because he knew that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will rule against him for the benefit of the Jew. Because he was wrong. He wronged the Jew. Rafat. قال, no, I want to go to Abi Barz. I want to go to Abi Barz. خايف من النبي. قل له تعالى القرآن والسنة هو تكست هو يا راجل تكست ميكسينج از باد تكست هو قرآن والسنة هو. يقول له لا 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 أصل معلش خليه كان وي جو تو لا يرضى. وإن الله سبحانه وتعالى توك ان اوث, فلا وربك يا محمد by your lord او محمد لا يؤمنون they will not have إيمان faith حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم until they appoint you as a judge over their disputes. Not only appointing you, your rulings. ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِّمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Then they will have no reservation in their chest regarding the rulings. You come and ask me about a ruling. I tell you, this is the ruling. Allah said, the Messenger said. Number one, you're not going to be a believer if you do not appoint Allah and His Messenger. Number two, you cannot be a believer if you do not accept the ruling of Allah and His Messenger internally and outside. فَلَا وَرَبِّكْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ. هذا قرآن. By your Lord, O Muhammad. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. They will not believe. حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ. Until they appoint you as a judge over their disputes. And once they learn the rulings, ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِّمَّا قَضَيْتْ. فالأهل النفاق لا لا ما يريد الله ورسوله. يقول لك سقراط قال وأفلاطون قال ومش عارف مين قال ما يريد يقول لك معلش اصل ظروفه معلش is the 21st century they always come up with an excuse but if you want if your agenda is to be granted dignity in the dunya the curriculum is the obedience to Allah and his messenger if you are a Muslim if you are a believer أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم في صحيح البخاري حديث regarding the event of Uhud when the non-Muslims came from Mecca to fight the Muslims in Medina فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم after holding a shura meeting decided to go and counter them in the vicinity of the area of Uhud and they knew that they will be outnumbered so they said okay let's use that top hill or that hill Jabal Samubil Jabal Rumah the mountain of the archers to be in our back to protect our back so we're just from this front only. And he selected an emir, a leader, his name is Abdullah ibn Jubayr. And he put with him 50 archers under his leadership. And he said this to them, stand up on the top of this mountain. Listen carefully to this. If you see the non-Muslims chasing us to Medina, do not come down until I let you know, until I command you. And if you see us chasing them to Mecca, do not come down until I command you. Yani, you cannot have a crystal clear command than this. They say black and white. ما في مجال للتأويل. No place for interpretation. ما في مجال. Clear. طيب. At the beginning, the Muslims won. They actually started chasing the non-Muslims. The majority of the archers came to Abdullah ibn Jubayr saying, we want to go and collect what they left behind. What we would call booties of war. Abdullah ibn Jubayr said, no. Remember what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. And he actually stayed with 10 of his, with him. And they died, those people, these companions, were amongst the 70 who died on this day. Shuf, the victory turned into a loss. When they came down, the non-Muslims already had a plan to wait for this to happen, and they attacked the Muslims from behind. What happened? Disobedience to Allah and His Messenger. I want to conclude by saying, a lot of Muslims, they say, how come we're humiliated? How come we are oppressed? How يا أخي كل محجمة دم في الأرض دم مسلم. يعني look at earth. Any bloodshed in the face of this earth right now is a blood of a Muslim. Look, I want you to go back and map earth. Any fight that is taking place right now, a blood of a Muslim. Muslims are being killed. Why? Where is Allah? Huh? We want. Ya Rajil, right here. I feel so sorry about brothers who go back to the so-called Muslim world. They come back depressed. Because wherever they go, it's like living in a non-Muslim country. Disobedience all over the place. Now, if you believe that victory comes from Allah, and the way to receive that victory is to obey Allah and His Messenger, why are you questioning the fact that you're not receiving it when you see with your own eyes that you're walking on text? That's crystal clear. Do you have doubt about not praying five times a day? I ask you, why you're not praying five times a day? Huh? You're wealthy, have to pay zakah. Why you're not paying your charity? Why? Huh? Why? I really wanna. I feel for you. It's a little bit edgy, you know. I understand, but if we want to help the Ummah, ya ikhwa, we have to change. We have to begin to obey Allah and His Messenger. And this would take place in your front first, you as a person first. A lot of the Muslims, they walk around saying, well, the communities, it change first. Change comes from within. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ. Allah will never change the condition of an ummah unless the individuals change. You change, I change, you change, I change, I change. Then the community here will change. Then the other community will change. And this will kick towards the change that we are seeking. But again, we're not seeking change. We're not seeking to be empowered to kill people. La wallahi. La wallahi. We want to benefit humanity. The world is desperate for the morals of Islam, for the belief that Islam has. I tell you, they are desperate. They are waiting for you. Please don't delay it. Change. Allahumma ighfir lana dunubana, israfana fi amrina, thabbit aqdamana, ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma arina al-haqq haqqan warzuqna attiba'a, arina al-batila batilan warzuqna istinaba. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهديين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم استعملنا ولا تستبدلنا يا أكرم الأكرمين. أقول قولي هذا.